Hi everyone, it's Bella from talktobella.com. Today I will be talking about what you should say or what you shouldn't say to a partner when they're going through hard times. Most people don't know how dangerous the words that come out of our mouths are. They just open their mouth and say whatever they want to say. I don't know how to explain this, but I'm going to try my possible best to make it very simple. You have a man, he doesn't have a job, or he had a job but lost his job. And the thing you do every morning when you wake up is to remind him he doesn't have a job. When you cook and you give to the kids, you don't give him. You tell him a real man provides for his family. When it's time for him to perform his conjugal rights as a husband, you deny him this. You say, a real man, you know, makes his wife happy, so she in turn, you know, makes him happy. You make him feel like nothing, you know. You turn him inside out. You yell at him, you fight him, you expose him to the neighbors. Why would you want to do that to somebody, you know, when things were good for him? He took care of you and everything. I don't understand. Why would you want to be that mean to somebody? I see women fighting their husbands over money for food. I see women holding their husband's clothes like this on the express or on their waist, telling them they didn't keep money at home. I see women, you know, bringing their men down because, you know, that man is not financially capable at the moment, or because something is happening to him and he wants to bring him down. My dear, that is not the way to go. Not at all, not at all, not at all. I see girls leaving their men because, you know, things are not okay for him now. Why would you want to be that person? You go and meet, okay, you meet somebody that takes care of you financially, but you're not happy. This is something that has been going on for a very long time. You see women, they are not ready to work. They just want to sit at home, you know, be housewives, be house girlfriends, slay queens. They don't want to work. They want somebody's son to go out there and hustle for them and bring the money home. And when that person doesn't meet up to their needs, that's when they start saying, useless man, you cannot take care of me. You cannot take care of the children. This, that, that. Why now? Eh? There are words when you say to a man, it will uplift his spirits. There are actions that you take that towards a man that motivates him to rise up each morning and want to put food on your table and that of the kids. But no, you want to bring him down. This is not for women alone. I see a lot of men shaming their girlfriends, saying you have mouth odor, you have body odor, you're fat, you don't have a job, you're not intelligent, you cannot speak English, you cannot do this one, you cannot do that one. At the end of the day, the girl will become suicidal, depressed. She would not have any self-value. She would not be so, her self-esteem will be very low. Why are you people like that? Relationship is not about what you can do outside. It is not a show of capability. It is not a show of this is how we are in a relationship. This is how we are in a relationship. It is what you do when no one is seeing you. Eh? I feel so sad talking about this. It is what you do when no other eyes are watching but yourself. Eh? It is inside. It is not outside. It is not what you do when your friends are around. It is not what you do when the girl's friends are around or the man's friends are around. It is what you do when nobody is watching. The words that come out of our mouth can make or break somebody. Depends how you use them. Please, if I am guilty, nobody. Sometimes we just say these things without thinking. Sometimes we think, we calculate it in our head and we still say it. What will it benefit us if we bring somebody up and break that person into pieces? Eh? The words of this our mouth is very dangerous. Please do not be the tool that the devil will use to, you know, destroy somebody's life. So your wife doesn't have a child yet, but you want to be disturbing, you know, reminding her every day that she's barren. So your husband's low sperm count is very low. You go and tell everybody that your husband is not a man. It is not the way to go. It is not the way to go at all. No, no. It is not. Uplift him. It even doesn't have to do with our partners. There are strangers out there that need words of encouragement. Not when you see somebody, you pass somebody, somebody smells. Wow. Try. See that fine girl, she dey smell. Why now? Come on. What will it take? You say, sister, I noticed this thing about you. Brother, I noticed this thing about you. Okay, this is my number. This is my email, my address. This is how I can help. Okay, take this 500, buy deodorant. Take this 200, buy toothpaste. What are you doing? You want to chastise somebody, but you don't want to be the instrument that would be used to help that person. Please, please. Eh? See, I don't... Well, see, different strokes for different folks, but we don't all have to be bad at the same time. We don't have to be bad at the same time. There are still many good eggs among us. Women, uplift your men. Men, you know, protect us. Don't let us be laughing stocks outside. This is all I have to say for today. I have, you know, written this down as usual, how I normally do it. I talk about it and I write it down for people that don't have enough, you know, internet to come to YouTube and check it out. You can go to my blog, www.talktobella.com. I'm on Twitter, talk to Isabella. I'm on Instagram, talk to Bella. But this talk is T-O-R-K, at Bella, you know, just, you know, same. Whenever you want to talk about something, write me, send me an email, as in I am here for you 247. You want to talk about something, you can find my WhatsApp number on my blog. You know, talk about anything, whatever is bringing you down, talk about it. I see so many sadness in the world and it weighs me down. You know, talk about whatever you want to talk about, and I know God is going to do something extraordinary in your life. Take care and have a nice day.